Hi, we'll be starting with rule number 32, that is the determination of value in respect of certain supplies. Subrule 1 states that notwithstanding anything contained in the provision of the chapter, the value supply in respect of those supplies mentioned below shall, at the option of the supplier, be in the manner provided herein after. So very simple, just a overriding provision saying that it doesn't matter what all is stated in the other valuation rules, the value of certain supplies at the option of the supplier will be as specified below. Now let's see the rule for the first type of transaction or supply that they have given. The most important as well is rule number 32, subrule 2. It talks about a value of supplies when there is money is going to be exchanged from one currency to another. That is, it's a supply which applies to currency dealers. So currency dealers have two options to value their supplies. One is option 1, which is given in your rule number 32, 2A. And your second option that they get is your rule number 32, 2B. One of the important aspects in the second option is that if you choose option number 2, you have to follow it for the entire part of the remaining year. So let's see what is this rule 32, 2A. We're going to do an in-depth analysis and trust me, it's really simple. Firstly, Forex dealers or those money exchangers, money converters, authorized dealers get two options as we discussed. One of the option is given in your rule 32, 2A and the other option is given in your rule 32, 2B. In 2A, if Indian rupees are involved, okay, like let's say foreign currency is being converted into Indian rupees, or rupees are being converted into foreign currency, then rule number 32, 2A, the first part applies. Here they have given you, if a RBI reference rate is available, then a certain kind of method is to be followed. And if the RBI reference rate is not available, then how do you value that supplies? Now, this was when Indian rupees was involved. What if Indian rupees are not involved at all? That is, both are being the currency that are being converted are foreign currencies. For example, dollars could be converted into pounds and vice versa, or euro will be converted into yen, etc. So here both the currency that are being involved or being converted are both foreign currencies and none of them are Indian currencies. This is the first option that the dealer can opt for. Or if the dealer wants, he can opt for option number 2 as well. But if he opts for option 2, he has to follow it for the remaining part of the entire year. Now let's get into the detailed provisions and see what it is. Now rule number 32.2 applies to foreign exchange dealers. Basically persons who are engaged in the purchase and sale of foreign currency. Now, what are these authorized dealers and who are these persons who are engaged in the business of buying and selling currency? So, in India, RBI is the custodian of foreign exchange. They do not deal themselves. They appoint or authorize certain dealers, authorized dealers. These authorized dealers, money exchangers, money converters, whatever name you call, they are entitled to deal, or you could say buy and sell foreign currencies. So generally you could see them, these kind of shops in your airports or sometimes in malls, or sometimes banks also act as authorized dealers. Okay, so this is something what it looks like. Let's see how do you value the supplies in case of this currency exchange. So the first option that is available to the dealer is given in your rule 32, 2A, and the first part of it is where a rupees is involved, rupee Indian currency is involved. So let's see, the rule is pretty simple. It says that the value of supply in respect of a foreign currency shall be the difference between the buying or the selling rate and the difference between either the buying or the selling rate and the RBI exchange rate into the total number of currencies that are going to be converted. Simple meaning, either a dealer, now this entire point is, this entire topic is from the forex dealer point of view, the foreign exchange dealer point of view, authorized dealer point of view. Either a dealer could buy the foreign currency or the dealer could sell the foreign currency. Yes or no? So maybe a dealer could end up buying dollars or he could end up selling dollars. So we will see what is to be done. How do you find the value in these cases? Now what happens? RBI issues a reference rate. RBI issues a reference rate. So first you need the RBI reference rate, and then you need to see what is the buying or what kind of a transaction it is. Is the dealer buying foreign exchange or the dealer is selling foreign exchange? You will simply take that. Let's say it's a buying rate, is buying foreign currency. So you will take the difference between the RBI rate and the buying rate, and wo tumhe ek currency ka milega. Waise total kitni currencies hai, मल्टीप्लाई करोगे तुमको टोटल वैल्यू ऑफ सप्लाई मिलेगा. सेम वे इफ द डीलर इज सेलिंग फॉरेन करेंसी देन यू विल टेक द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द आरबीआई रेफरेंस रेट एंड द सेलिंग रेट. वेरी वेरी सिंपल. तो ये दोनों ही तुम किसके साथ में कंपेयर कर रहे हो? विद द आरबीआई रेफरेंस रेट. ना आरबीआई इश्यूज दिस काइंड ऑफ रेफरेंस रेट with respect to dollars, pound, yen, etc. This helps in calculation of the value of supply. Simply, tumhe kya karna hai? You don't have to think too much. You just have to take a difference of them and multiply it with the total number of currency. You'll get your value of supply. Let's understand with the help of an example. Now, first, what if the RBI reference rate is not available? Now, not all kinds of currencies RBI issues a reference rate. So it is possible RBI has not issued a reference rate for a specific currency. Then how do you value it? So it says that the value of supply in such cases will be 1% of the gross Indian rupees provided or received by the person changing the money. So whatever rupees is involved, uska 1% is the deemed to be the value of supply. Now let's understand this with the help of example. So in this illustration, the amount to be converted is 65,000. The rate as per USD is rupees 65 per USD. And you will see the, so whatever rate is there, you will compare it with what? Jo bhi buying say rate ho ya selling rate ho, तुमको कंपेयर करना है आरबीआई रेफरेंस रेट के साथ में दोनों का डिफरेंस. तो जो भी रहेगा तुम डिफरेंस देखो, तुमको पता चलेगा टू रुपीज द डिफरेंस 65 माइनस 63, टू रुपीज पर यूएस डॉलर्स. अब ऐसे कितने, ये तो सिर्फ एक डॉलर पे डिफरेंस है, ऐसे कितने डॉलर्स कन्वर्ट होने वाले? 1000. सो यू विल हैव 2000 रुपीज एज द वैल्यू ऑफ सप्लाई. In the next case, this is the first case, this is 1000 convert ho rahe the. So you just take the difference and multiply it and you come to know 2000 rupees is your value of supply. In the second case, the RBI reference rate is not available. So some kind of currency which might be like a really not a very famous currency that you're dealing in. So RBI must not have issued a reference rate. In that case, you will have to take 1% of the rupee value. That is, rupee value कितना है यहाँ पे? 65,000 का 1% निकालना पड़ेगा, which is 650 rupees. Really simple. Now let's see the second case and I want you to try. Okay. Now on 10th June, Mr. Smith converted 1000 US dollars into 65,000 rupees at the rate of 64 per USD. through the northern money changers. The reference rate as on that date was 63. So very, very simple. What do you have to do? You have to take the difference between the RBI reference rate and the transaction. You will come to know it is rupees 1. How did you get that? 64 minus 63. Ab aise kitne convert ho rahe into 1000. So you will come to know it is rupees 1000 is the value of supply. Okay, into rupees 1000, you will come to know 1000 is there and GST will be levied on this amount. If RBI reference rate in this case was not there, ye reference rate socho nahi tha, then you would take 1% of the 64,000. So jo rupee value tha uska 1% de loge tum of 60,000, it's rupees 640. Okay, so very simple. Now we'll take a scenario where both the currency that are being converted are foreign currencies, where a dollar is being converted into euro, a euro is being converted into pound, etc. But an Indian currency is not involved. So how do you value when an Indian currencies are not involved and foreign exchange, you're converting one foreign currency into another foreign currency? So the value is given very simple. You'll take 1% of the lesser of the two foreign currencies when converted into Indian rupees. Okay, so let's understand this with the help of an example. If a person has exchanged 100 euros by $120, so we can understand that euros, that is 100 euros, are being converted into $120. So as per the rule, both these two foreign currencies have to be converted into Indian rupees. At the time of exchange rate, euro is rupees 77 and dollars is rupees 65. So we'll convert them into Indian rupees, where we'll come to know this is 7700 and this is rupees 7800 rupees. So whatever is the lesser of the two foreign currencies, that is 7700, 1% you will take it. You will take 1% of the lesser of the two foreign currencies when they are converted into Indian rupees. So the answer is that the value of supply will be rupees 77. So super simple. Now a dealer can also opt for option 2, which is given in your rule 32.2b. But there is a condition that if you follow or opt for rule 32.2b, you will have to follow it for the entire year and such option shall not be withdrawn during the remaining part of that financial year. Now rule, let's see what the rule exactly says. So it works something how income tax slab rates work. That is why it is also called as the slab method. So rule 32.2b says that at the option of the supplier, the value of supply in respect of foreign currencies shall be deemed to be the following. So for the first 1 lakh, it will be 1% of the gross amount subject to a minimum of 250 rupees. Amount exceeding 1 lakh, so the amount above 1 lakh up to 10 lakhs, what you need to do? You need to take 1000 rupees plus 0.5% of the gross amount exceeding 1 lakh up to 10 lakhs. Ab ye kya hai samajhte hain? अगर अमाउंट एक्सीड हो रहा है 1 lakh, लेट्स से इट इज अ 5 lakh रुपीज, सो द फर्स्ट 1 lakh का यू विल टेक 1%, इट इज हाउ मच? 1% ऑफ 1 lakh, इट इज रुपीज 1000. तो ये तो आ ही जाएगा, तो यहां पे इनबिल्ट हो रहा है. एंड ऑन दैट एक्सेस अमाउंट बियॉन्ड 1 lakh, सो अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग 1 lakh अप टू 10 lakh का यू हैव टू टेक 0.5% अप टू 10 lakh rupees. And if the figure is above 10 lakhs, okay, the amount that you want to convert is above 10 lakhs, then the first 1 lakh pe 1000 to aa hi raha hai. The balance above 1 lakh to 10 lakhs, that is above 1 lakh to 10 lakhs is 9 lakh rupees, ka 0.5% you will take. That is how much? 9 lakhs ka 0.5%, it is 4500. समझ में आ रहा है? फर्स्ट 1 लाख का तो हो ही गया 1000, ये ऊपर से ही आ जाएगा। 1 लाख के बियॉन्ड टू 10 लाख दे आर सेइंग टेक 0.5%। सो 0.5% ऑफ द अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग 1 लाख अप टू 10 लाख रुपीज। सो 0.5% ऑफ 9 लाख विल बी 4500। सो एंड द अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग 10 लाख अगर हुआ तो फर्स्ट 10 लाख पे तो 5500 आ ही रहा है, ये दोनों को ऐड करेंगे हम लोग तो 5500 तो आ ही जाएगा, बिकॉज फर्स्ट 1 लाख पे दिस बैलेंस पे इतना, तो दोनों को मिला के यू विल कम टू नो इट इज 5500 तो आ ही रहा है अप टू 10 लाख रुपीज। नाउ एंड यू हैव टू एड 0.10% ऑफ द अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग 10 लाख रुपीज, ओके, सब्जेक्ट टू अ मैक्सिमम ऑफ ₹160। तो जैसे मिनिमम अमाउंट सेट कर दिया था ₹250, मैक्सिमम अमाउंट भी सेट कर दिया इज ₹60,000। सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दिस विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन एग्जाम्पल। द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग इन द इलस्ट्रेशन इफ दे गिवन यू दैट सपोज द अमाउंट दैट यू वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट, ओके, द अमाउंट यू वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट इज ₹6,500। सो कैन यू टेल मी कौन से कैटेगरी में आएगा, फर्स्ट सेकेंड थर्ड, इन विच कैटेगरी इट विल कम? इट विल कम इन द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी। सो फर्स्ट कैटेगरी का रूल क्या है, 1% ऑफ द ग्रॉस अमाउंट सब्जेक्ट टू मिनिमम ऑफ 250। सो इफ इट इज 6500 तो 1% ऑफ 6500 और 250 विच एवर इज हायर, तो ये 65 और 250 रुपीज, विच एवर इज हायर तो 250 रुपीज विल बी टेकन। नाउ द सेकेंड सिनेरियो, इफ द अमाउंट दैट यू आर कन्वर्टिंग इज 65,000, सो अगेन यू विल टेक 1% ऑफ 65,000 और 250 रुपीज, विच एवर इज हायर, सो द आंसर विल बी 650 रुपीज। नाउ लेट्स टेक द अमाउंट इज बियॉन्ड द थर्ड सिनेरियो। तो ये फर्स्ट सिनेरियो था, ये सेकेंड सिनेरियो था, थर्ड सिनेरियो, इफ द अमाउंट टू बी कन्वर्टेड इज बियॉन्ड 1 लाख, सो फॉर द फर्स्ट 1 लाख यू विल टेक, सो दे हैव गिवन यू डायरेक्टली ऑल्सो, इंस्टेड ऑफ यू नो गेटिंग इन टू दिस हैसल, यू कैन डायरेक्टली से दिस दैट इज द अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग 1 लाख, सो इट्स कम्स इन द सेकेंड कैटेगरी। सो यू विल टेक 1000 प्लस 0.5% ऑफ दैट एक्सेस अमाउंट, सो 1000 तो ऐड कर ही लेंगे, प्लस 1 लाख के बियॉन्ड कितना एक्सेस है, 5 लाख 50,000 का 0.5%, सो यू एड इट अप यू विल गेट योर 3750। द नेक्स्ट सिनेरियो दे हैव गिवन यू, इफ इट इज 65 लाख देन व्हाट इज इट गिवन, इट कम्स इन द थर्ड कैटेगरी। अगर थर्ड कैटेगरी में है अमाउंट एक्सीडिंग दिस, सो यू विल टेक 5500 तो ऐड करना ही है, प्लस 10 लाख के बियॉन्ड जितना भी है उसका कितना परसेंटेज लेना है, 0.10% ऑफ दैट अमाउंट ऑफ द एक्सेस अमाउंट। तो एक्सेस अमाउंट कितना होगा 10 लाख के बियॉन्ड, 55 लाख का 10% एंड अप टू 5000, सो हाउ मच यू गेट इट, 10,500। बट इफ यू रिमेंबर, इफ इन द थर्ड कैटेगरी देर इज अ अपर लिमिट ऑल्सो गिवन ऑफ 60,000। इन द नेक्स्ट इलस्ट्रेशन इफ यू सी द फिफ्थ वन, इफ द फिगर इज 6 crores 50 lakhs, इन सच केसेस यू विल टेक 50,000 प्लस 10% ऑफ दैट एक्सेस अमाउंट, सो 6 crores 40 lakhs का 10% यू विल टेक प्लस 5000 सब्जेक्ट टू अ मैक्सिमम ऑफ 60,000। सो सिंस इट कम्स बियॉन्ड 60,000 वी विल सेट इट अप टू द मैक्सिमम लिमिट स्पेसिफाइड दैट इज 60,000 रुपीज। सो सुपर सिंपल।